So he's famously the man that predicted the credit crunch. Now Sir Vince Cable says we're heading for another economic crash if Theresa May wins the election.
The former business secretary lost his seat in 2015, but is hoping to be re-elected next month. Anne joins us now. Good to see you again.
Good morning.
Nice to see you this morning. How do you feel it's going so far? It's not been a particularly easy week, has it, for the Lib Dems? One Liberal Democrat candidate suspended, another member has been sacked with anti-Semitic accusations, and another one has decided to pull out because they're buying a house and it's not the right time for them.
Yeah.
Doesn't feel particularly good, does it?
Well, these are little bumps. I mean, the big picture is that although we started from virtually rock bottom in terms of public support, we've had a massive increase in membership. Our opinion poll rating is rising as people become more exposed to our big views. And this election actually is a much bigger issue than whether somebody's moving their house. It's about the future of the country, whether we have Brexit.
I think that's quite surprising, because it's about the future of the country. So you would think someone who wanted to have the honour and the responsibility of being part of the future of that company and helping to make decisions wouldn't worry about their house move rather than that opportunity.
I think we're all disappointed, but this is one of many, many candidates in many, many seats.
I think
I want to concentrate on the big
picture. Yeah, I think a few people would argue they're not just little bumps, not least the sacking of one of your members and also the suspension.
But Tim Farron dealt with that very effectively.
Yeah, let's come back to that. What you're saying today is that you feel like we're heading for another economic crash if Theresa May wins the election. If we look at the figures that have been released, there's really good news. There's only good news in the economy at the moment, as I'm sure you appreciate. The economy grew more than previously in the final 3 months of 2016. There's revised growth for this year from 1.4% up to 2%. The FTSE 100 is up 16%. House prices are continuing to rise.
Well, it's precisely the good news that worries me, because we were here a decade ago and it was very much like that. We had, you know, all the numbers looked good. A lot of consumer spending, a lot of consumer credit, house prices were going up exactly as they are now.
So you're not scaremongering then, Vince?
I think when I was talking about this a decade ago, I certainly wasn't stammering, but I was worried, and I am worried now, that we're getting into the same old kind of boom-bust cycle.
So what's the basis for your worry, other than a natural pessimism, things are going well?
No, I'm not a natural pessimism, and I was in government during the tough years after the financial crisis, and I was optimistic we were getting some of the basic things right. No, what underlies it is the fact that if our economy is going to be strong in the longer term, and, you know, post-Brexit, whatever happens there, we've got to have much more investment. We've got to have people investing in skills and science and things. And this is not happening. What is happening is that the economy is moving along, as you quite rightly say, but it's in the wrong way. It's financed through consumer credit, through higher house prices. We've been here before. We were here, it was like this before the crash. It was like this in the late 1980s, which also ended very badly. And, you know, the British people are used to this boom-bust cycle, and it is an illusion.
So what do we done about it then? Because there's one thing predicting it, another thing solving it. And as you say, you were there when we were trying to deal with the fallout last time. How can we avoid it this time?
Well, to shift the emphasis of the economy into investment and exports. Of course, that's easier said than done. The role of government is to get on with, and to give Theresa May credit, she's actually adopted some of the ideas we had in the coalition about industrial strategy, about apprenticeships, which I launched with my colleagues back in 2010. That's where the focus should be. Investment, trying to raise productivity, and as you do that, you then raise wages. It's getting the fundamentals right, not just this kind of easygoing credit card boom. That is a very dangerous road.
Does it worry you, Vince, that you predicted the credit crunch, you were there trying to help the government and the parliament realise that this was going to happen? You then became part of a coalition, and yet your constituents had so little faith in you once that had happened that they didn't vote for you in the last election just 2 years ago. So despite all your experience, and you are hugely experienced, and we know that, and hugely respected, the people on the ground where you are didn't feel that you were the right person for them.
Well, I don't think it was a local and personal decision. I mean, it may have been for one or two
individuals. But it was a comment on a broader
problem which the Lib Dems had at the end of the coalition government. We tended to be blamed for the bad things.
Do you think you've turned that
around?
And
the Conservatives were very skillful in exploiting a fear of the Labour Party.
So do you think you've been able to turn that around?
Yes, and the big picture has changed. I mean, nobody now seriously expects a Labour government. And so all the people, you know, across, not just in my patch, but elsewhere, who voted Conservative to avoid Labour and the SNP, I mean, they've got no worries this time. The Labour Party are not going to win. So I think that's changed the atmosphere. I think a lot of people, certainly Meyer and others, have expressed what you call buyer's remorse. They actually regretted the fact that a lot of us lost and would like to see the balance return. So I'm much more optimistic than I was last time.